Hi guys, my name is Ferdy and in this video I will show you step by step how you can upload your created course to Udemy, a platform where you can sell your course to a ton of visitors. In this video I will show you how to create a Udemy account, how to create your first course on Udemy, how to create a landing page for your course, how to upload your videos of the course, update a course image and submit your course for a review. This video is part of the BioBest course, a free course where I will show you from scratch how to create an online business. You can watch all the videos on YouTube by clicking on the link in the video or in the description. So why choose Udemy? I have two reasons. The first one is that Udemy has a ton of visitors that are willing to buy courses. The second one is that it is really user-friendly. The negative side about Udemy is that your course will be promoted for sometimes just $10. But at the other side, if you get a lot of visitors that will buy your course for $10 per day, you still earn a nice amount of money. Having said that, let's get started. So in order to upload our course to Udemy, we need to go to Udemy. And now it's getting fun because now we are going to make money. I can close this, say okay. And I need to sign up. I'm a new user. My full name is David Korp. That's my alias, Korp. My email is davidferdinandps@gmail.com. We did it all in earlier videos and I need to create a password, which is this one. Could be stronger, yes. I could also be stronger. Do I want to get news from Udemy? No. I click on sign up. And here we are. DK reminds me of Donkey Kong, which I played on the Nintendo and on Nintendo 64. So now I have an account. I click on teach on Udemy. I click over here and I want to become an instructor. So I click on become an instructor. What kind of teachings have you done before? Online. And you can fill in whatever you want to fill in over here. I've experience with online teaching. Continue. How much of Video Pro are you? Well, to be honest, I think I have videos ready to upload. So continue. Do you have an audience to share your course with? Well, I have, but I don't know if I want to use it because I want to start from scratch. So you know what? Not at the moment. Continue. Jump into course creation. I can create my course. So of course, I will create my course by clicking here. First, let's find out what type of course you are making. I'm making a course type of course. Continue. Okay, how about a working title? Now that's funny, learn Photoshop from scratch because that is what I want to teach. And if I go to Udemy and I search for Photoshop, let me see what will pop up. Ultimate Photoshop Training from Beginner to Pro, nice title. Photoshop Beginner's Mastery from Zero to Hero in Photoshop. The crazy thing, this is only 2.5 hours. This one is 13 hours. This is what I'm thinking about, making a course about 13 hours because that is something that sells. But 2.5 hours, I have already 2.5 hours in video as far as I know. And I'm not done with the course yet. 8.5 hours. So I will just call this Complete Photoshop Course. And it's quite a statement I make because it's not complete yet, but I want it to be. And my idea is to make it for free for the first 100 people or until my course is finished, but I will take a look at it later because I want to see people that get the course and I want to get feedback and I want to get ratings. Ratings is the name of the game. If you have good ratings, you will be found better in Udemy because Udemy wants to sell people the best. If there's a course that has 3 stars, it will not be on top over here because Udemy doesn't want to scare people away. Complete Photoshop course for beginners. Because I really focus on beginners. Continue. What category fits the knowledge you will share? I think design. Continue. How much time can you spend creating your course per week? Well, I have lots of flexibility. So I'd say 5+ hours. And I click on create the course. The description you will write here will help students decide if your course is for them. So what will students learn in your course? And now I can take a look at different courses. So I go to Udemy again. And again, I will not copy, but I will model things. Photoshop. just to get some inspiration. So let me see more. What will you learn? What will students learn? Well, to start with, how to get Photoshop and how to get a free trial. Should I have capitals at every beginning of every word? No. So I say how to get Photoshop. How to get a free trial. The difference just between RAW, JPEG, GIF, and PNG and GIF files. How to use Adobe Lightroom. We want to give people the idea that they get a lot of information, because let me ask you, would you go with your complete family to Hawaii? Everything will be taken care of if it will be a total amount of $100. I think your answer will be yes. And why? Because then you will be over-delivered, because normally it costs a few thousand dollars. And if you would get it for $100, it will be an amazing chance. So that's the same thing I want to have over here. I want to over-deliver. So you see a Photoshop course, but you will also learn about Lightroom, about Bridge. So I want to over-deliver so that people want to buy my course. And I'm not going to lie over here, because this is all you will learn about Lightroom, how to use Adobe Bridge, how to work with layers. And again, I need to remove all those capitals. Let me see what else. Well, there's so much I want to cover. I can just go over here to Finder, to Movies, Photoshop course, Finals. How to work with different screen modes, create adjustment layers, give a lot of information over here about your course, learn how to crop images. How to use the Liquid tool. Okay, that's okay for now. Are there any course requirements or this one? Let me see. I don't see this. Oh, here. Are there any course requirements? You need a computer. You need an internet connection to download. But I think this is logic, because I think I should not even mention it, because if you can watch this course, you can also, no, you don't need that. You need a computer. You do not need any prior knowledge about Photoshop. Who are your target students? Well, let me see. People who have no experience with Photoshop and want to learn it. People who want to learn how to edit photos or images. People who want to enhance images. Learn how to. Okay, that's okay. What I can do now, I can save it. So I click on save, and then I can go to the second area, the course structure. You need to create an outline, introduce yourself, create momentum. It should be at least 30 minutes of total video. Yes? So then I need to go to set up a test video. So I need to send a video to test it. And I will get feedback from real people. So I've shown you this already in different videos. If you go to ferdycorp.com/new-business. Here's the video, the introduction, how to develop the right mindset, how to find your niche, how to learn a skill and teach it others, and how to create an instructional video. I'm talking about this and how to edit it. So you can watch those videos over here. So what I will do, I'll just create a test video. Let me see. Click here. I have my equipment. Record a test of 1 to 3 minutes. Okay, get started. The language is English. We can provide tips for your production. Yeah. I'm filming myself. I'm filming my computer screen. I have other, the Shure SM7B, or is it with an H? Camera type. I use an iPhone in one of the intros, but I'm using the Canon 5D Mark IV. Software, ScreenFlow, operating system, Mac. Okay, so I need to downsize my video. You can watch this if you want to. I think I am a pro already. So you can watch those videos. Film your video, and I will select the video. Movies, Photoshop course, finals. There it is. I open it. And this is the first video I upload to Udemy. If you think about everything, I've been doing this for 2 months already. I know I did not work on it every day, but 2 months ago I started with the idea to create this course and to create a Photoshop course. Right now we're going to upload it, and it's not finished yet, but the start is there, so I'm really happy. I hope you are too. And it's processing, and I can submit it for feedback already. Great work. Within 2 business days I will get feedback, and you will receive an email when it's ready. So I click on finish. And I can click on exit. So welcome to teaching on Udemy. Okay. What I want to do, I want to go to my course over here at the left. I click over here, and I hope I can upload videos already. So then I need to go to curriculum. Now we can start putting this course together. So again, I go to Finder. I work with chapters. I've numbered them like this. So what we have over here is a section, and in those section we have lectures. So you can see a section as a chapter and a lecture as a video. So let me see here at finals. The first chapter is introduction to Photoshop. And what will students be able to do at the end? They can see what is possible within Photoshop. Download Photoshop and the course files, or the course practice files. Save it. The first video, what's it called? I go to Finder, I just say enter, Command C, Command V, and then I remove this. Save the lecture. And then I create an outline. I rather create an outline, so I click on the plus over here. Lecture, and then I go to the second one. Copy, paste, and remove this. How to get Photoshop. Add the lecture. The third one, lecture. Copy, paste. So that's chapter one, section one. And now I want to create a new section. So I go over here below, and when I hover over it, you see this appearing. And now the second chapter is, let me see, getting familiar with Photoshop. Sometimes I want to check if a word is correct. So I copy it. I go to Google and it is correct. It could look really stupid when you have a lot of errors over here. What will students learn? How to navigate through Photoshop and change basic settings. I don't know about you, but I'm getting excited because we're finally going to upload this. I want to add the section. And the great thing about what we're doing is we are working really hard for a certain time. And after that, we can reap what we have sown. So we have sown a lot of time in doing this, in creating a course. We've made no penny with it at all, but I hope that will change. So I copy this again and I click on the plus lecture. You also can add quizzes. This one. Edit. I can close this. And I will do it like this. Lightroom. Adobe. Add the lecture. Copy. And sometimes when a title is really short, I will just say, you know what? Zooming in Photoshop to make it a little bit more clear. Screen modes. So I guess you know by now how it is done. New chapter, new lecture. Click on the plus over here. So what I will do now, I will upload the first few videos and I can also bulk upload, and that's what I like. Otherwise you need to do it all one by one. So if I want to upload everything to Udemy, I click on plus content, upload a video, and then you can edit from the library. So here we can upload all the videos to, or over here, select a video, this one. So then it's working like that. But what I'd rather do is the bulk upload. So I click over here and then I can drag all the files in there. So I select the second one until the latest one, except for the 720 one. And since the files are quite big, I should export them actually as smaller files. It can take quite a long time because if I take a look at the folder, get info, it's 4.5 gigabytes. So it will take quite a while. So I'll pause it and then I will be back with you. So I click on upload and it will start. I will be back with you when I'm done uploading all those files. So everything is uploaded. So what I can do now, I go to the second lecture, click on content plus, video, add from library. Now I search for 01.02 and I click on select. The third video, video, add from library. 01.03. There it is. Select 2.1 or 02.01. And that's how I can work more efficient. 02.02. So let me fast forward. So what I need to do now, based on my overview over here, I should add all those sections and all those lectures. So I will be back with you when I've done that. So I uploaded and configured 7 sections. The course is not finished yet, but I just want to show you how you can upload it. And when we have done that, we can click on preview as an instructor or as a student. So let's do it as a student. So this is what it will look like. You can play. And you can go over here. And over here, when you've watched the video, you can check it, or it will be checked automatically when you've watched the whole video. And then you can see the progress. Here you see it's by David Korp. 2.5 hours of video. Well, I want to bring that up to 14 hours. So there's a lot to do, but I want to start somewhere. So this is okay. Let's see. If I scroll up all the way, I can go to captions. I don't want to do anything with that, but you can do that. You can upload it over here. And then we have the course landing page. The title, Complete Photoshop Course for Beginners. Course subtitle, Become a Photoshop Pro. And here we need to give a course description. So again, I can take a look at other courses. Here's a description. Very smart, a massive giveaway, latest Photoshop version. So here you need to sell your course. Why should people get your course? And as I said before, you should over deliver. So I will type. So something like this. Okay, basic info, United States, English. Let me see, English, US. Select a level, all levels, or you know what, let's focus on beginner level. Design, graphic design. We need to have a course image. And if we take a look at course images, if I search for Photoshop, you see a lot of things like these. I like something like this. If you want to watch how to create a thumbnail, you can click over here. So I will upload mine, 750 by 422 pixels. Over here, just simple, an image of myself and the Photoshop logo. That's enough for me. I rather do not use text. And if you want to know more, the course image quality standards need to be accepted. Content save area for the mobile, because on the mobile it should also be seen. Like that. It should be relevant. Be careful with a lot of text. Here, that's like this. Do not use it. Use high quality stock photos and not too much with text. But you can read through this. So this is fine. Photo of myself and the Photoshop logo. Then this is really important. You need to have a promotion video. And if you want to know how it's done, then you can go to ferdycorp.com/new-business. And there I will show you how it is done. How to create an instructional video. Well, here I also talk about the introduction, creating an intro video and showing your screen and how to edit it in Adobe Premiere. So you can create your own intro video. You can also go to themeforest.net and then go to video and search for promo in After Effects. And then you get something like this. And then you can fill in all the video files so it looks like it's your video. And you can have nice music underneath it here at audio. So that's what you can do. But for now, I skip this. And we must complete our profile before we can publish a course. Name, image, short summary of your background, 50 words minimum. Okay, so I save this. It is saved. So what I can do, I can update my profile. It opens in a new tab, David Korp, Photoshop expert. So that's a text about me. My language is English. My website URL, at this moment it is still ferdycorp.com. In the course I will also create a website, but at this moment I do not have it yet. I have no Twitter, I have Facebook, ferdycorp.hook. I have no LinkedIn and I have YouTube. So I save it. Profile picture. I upload an image of myself. Here it is. No cropping. I can save it, or you know what, crop it. Save it. Okay. And then there are privacy settings. Show your profile, yes. Show your courses. Okay, I can close this. I need to refresh this page. Let me see what it says. Okay, everything is complete over here. So now I can go to the price and coupons. And in order to complete a premium instructor application, we should click over here. So I click on save and continue. Save and continue. I can skip this. Okay, I need to agree with this. Save and continue. Yes, I want to choose. I've read and agree. Yes. Yes, they will give discounts and all that stuff. Save and continue. And I would like to have PayPal as my payment provider. So I click on login with PayPal. You need to have a PayPal account. I have a video about it. I will link it over here. And I agree. Your PayPal account is now linked with Udemy. Return to Udemy. Okay, it's active. Just like that. Great. Well, I go back to course landing page, and just to make things sure, I refresh the page. Great, then we can go back to pricing and coupons. And keep in mind, you get followers, you get people that buy your course, and they will be on your list, they will be your students, and you can send students emails. But there are two kinds of emails, information emails like, hey, I've added a new chapter or section to my course, so feel free to access it. And promotional emails. Promotional emails are like, hey, I have a new course for just $10. You can enroll it. And when you have a lot of students that bought it for free, like 25,000, and the next course is $10, it can give you a huge boost in your sales. But when you decide to create a price, and after that, you want to put it back to free, and after that you want to put it back to paid, you cannot send any promotion emails anymore to the people that are your students. So keep in mind that when you have it for free, you can make it paid only once, and when you go back to free after that, then you can send no promotion emails anymore. So I start with free because I want to get a few people that enroll to my course, or if you're really sure that you can go for the paid version. And how it works, you can say $29.99, and then Udemy will give discount to the buyer. So they will probably buy it for $10. And when they buy it through Udemy, it can be that you receive around $2.50 or $5, depending on how people bought your course. If they buy it through you, you get around 94% of the price. So then you will get $9.40. I will start making it for free, save it. And since we have it for free, we cannot create coupon codes. If it's paid, you can create a coupon code that says, hey, with this code, you can get it for just $10 or $8 or $15. So course messages. When people welcome, you can say this. Thank you for enrolling this course. I do my best to update the course now and then and give you the best. Feel free to share feedback with me and ask questions when you get stuck. Good luck with the course. Something like that. I can also say this course is free because I am still expanding it When it is complete, I will let you know. You will keep access to the complete course when it is finished. And I will raise the price. Something like that. Cheers, David Korp. And then a congratulations message when people finish the course. Congrats, you are now a Photoshop Pro Master Creator. I hope you had a great journey and will have a lot of people you can serve with your new skills. Feel free to give feedback about the course. Have a great day. Cheers, David Korp. So something like that. And what we can do now, I can save it, of course. I can submit this for a review, and I will do that because then they will manually check this course and see if it is okay. And they can give me feedback. They can publish it and give me feedback. They can decline it and give me feedback. So I will just do it, and then I will let you know how they will respond. So I click on submit for review. To maintain the trust, I need to verify some things. So I click on start verification process. I created most of all content of this course. This one. Continue. Okay, I'm from the Netherlands. So I selected David Korp 9086. 36 in Jan Luiken Street 3141 PN. Verify my information. Yes, thank you for successfully completing verification. To submit your course for review, please click continue below. Continue. Was that it? I guess. Okay, why can't I submit my review? I need to go to the course landing page. Over here, I should say, Photoshop. CC 2018. Okay. Save. Maybe I should check this first. Film and edit. And now it's also checked. So now it's time to submit for a review. I click over here. This is a thing you can only do one time. Complete Photoshop course for beginners. Once you set your course URL, it cannot be changed. So I think, you know what, it's okay. Or I take a look at a few other ones. Ultimate Photoshop training from beginner to pro. Complete Photoshop course from beginner to pro. Submit for review. Congratulations on finishing your course. You are just one step away from having your course published on Udemy. Our team will review your course within the next 2 business days and get back to you. Great. So I need to keep track of my Gmail account. And when I get an email, I will let you know. And now we have almost published our course. How amazing is that? I will skip this for you, so you will see me back in 2 seconds. So it is now 2 days later, and I got some feedback about my course. So I can click here. So if you go to udemy.com, you need to be logged in. You go to instructor, and there it is. See feedback. And they say they want me to add a last lecture because in the latest video of my course, I say in the next video, we'll do this and that. So that's really sharp from them. I go to curriculum new video, advanced selections, add lecture, content, video, select video. And here it is, the latest one. I open it. Now it will be uploaded. So I submit my course again and we will see what will happen. I got an email from Udemy that says, "Congratulations, David, your Udemy course has been approved." And what happened, it went live immediately for free. So I have already more than 3,000 students. So I click on the link, complete Photoshop course for beginners. And then I go to messages. And when people respond to your openings message, like, "Hey, congratulations with this course, good luck," people can reply and then you get a message. So what I want to do now, I want to go to the instructor area and I hover over the amount of students and I click on see students. And here you see all the students that signed up and you can see how much progress they made already. And the downside of a free course is that a lot of people will enroll and they will never log in. They just want something for free, maybe for later, but a lot of times you see that people never will log in. Another thing is that a few people completed the course within one day, 100%. And it can say that people are downloading your stuff and selling it on the internet or they publish it for free somewhere else. So that's the downside of releasing a course for free. I did it because I want to get a few rates so people can say what they think about it and it can help other people to buy my course. Let's go to the price and coupons. And it says over here, "Before updating the price of your course, please be aware that switching the price of your course between free and paid more than once will result in restrictions in your promotional announcements." So you cannot change all the time between paid and free and paid and free, and then you have a lot of students and then you create a promotional email saying you have a new course for $10. That's not possible when you go from free to paid more than one time. So I have more than 3,000 students. From now on, I want to make it paid. And because the course is not finished yet, I want to sell it for $90.99. I click on save and now I can start to make money. We can also make use of coupon codes. And the great thing about coupon codes is that when people buy it through your coupon code, you get more than 95% of the money. So first we need to create a coupon code. I call it "for my friends" and the coupon type can be free or a discounted price. I want to have a discounted price of $9.99. How many coupons should be available? I want it to be for 1,000 people. And should there be a deadline? So for instance, for the next 48 hours or for the next week, or should there not be a deadline? It's optional. If you leave this blank, there is no deadline. The course coupon code should be in capitals. So I change it to capitals and now I create the coupon and there it is. Now I can get the link. So I click on it and it's already copied to the clipboard. So if I paste it in a new tab, it will look like this. So what I need to do now, I need to share this link wherever I can. I should not spam people with it, but if you have a Facebook profile, a Facebook page, a Facebook business page, an Instagram account, Twitter account, an email list, YouTube channel, you can share it over there. And then people can buy it and you will earn money. I don't have Facebook friends, but I do have a Facebook page. So I will share that over there and then I will create a story around it. And I will do the same on YouTube with a YouTube post. And now let's take a look at the results. So it's a few days later now. And when I go to instructor, I see I've earned $43.15 and my course rating is 4.46. And if I click on see reviews and I scroll down, I see I'm a little bit above average of all the ratings. The subcategory rating is 4.4 and mine is 4.46. And this is a 5-star and this is a 3-star. And it says average. And that's the thing I did wrong. I did upload a course that is not completed yet. So what I advise you to do, upload the course when it is completed. I want to upload it because I wanted to finish this tutorial and I was going on vacation. So I was a bit impatient and that's why I get this rating. When I get a bad rating, I ask people why it is. So you can click on edit or respond. I can edit it and they can respond if they want to. And they can also change it later. So if I would answer them and say, "Hey, I saw your feedback. I worked on it. Can you review it again?" Then you can get better reviews. So now you should promote it. And one really important thing, let me see if I go to courses. I click on it, edit, manage. There's one important thing I've not done yet and I should do that. If I go to the course landing page, and I scroll down, I have an image, but I have no promotional video yet. And it says that you will enroll 5 times more people. We have a great promotional video. Well, I'm working on it, so I will upload it soon. And then if you want to see the results, you can go to ferdycorp.com/new-business. And here you see how much I have made so far. And this is updated the 8th of May. And my goal is still $1,000. Meanwhile, I learned some new things, which changed my mind about the $1,000. I want to make $100,000. And not only with a Photoshop course, I have a lot of new plans and I will also show them over here in the BioBest course. So thank you for watching this video. Good luck with uploading your course and making money through Udemy. If you have a question, leave a comment and subscribe to this YouTube channel and click on the bell icon so you get a notification when I upload a new video. Have a great day and you'll see me the next time. Bye bye.